Hey guys, remember Intel's first CPU, the Intel 4004? The chip was released back in 1971. It had 2,300 transistors, measuring at 10 micrometers, and ran at 740 kHz. It doesn't seem much, but for its application at the time, it was sufficient. Let's move forward to 2016 and reveal Intel's latest processor, the Xeon E5-2699V4, which comes at a staggering 7.2 billion transistors, measuring at only 14 nanometers. Running at 2.2 GHz and can turbo up to 3.2 GHz on each of its 22 hyper-threaded cores. This advancement only happened in a span of nearly 5 decades. It was observed that every 2 years, overall processor power will double. This is called Moore's Law by Gordon Moore. However, in recent years, there's a stagnation in processing power, meaning Moore's Law is slowly getting irrelevant, but that's beside my point. Here's my point. Computers are getting faster and more efficient. So what can an operating system do with these enhancements? Use concurrency, of course. Surely, you want to get the most out of your limited resources like the RAM and the CPU. This is, in fact, one of the main objectives of an operating system, to make full use of hardware. By enabling concurrency, the operating system can do more things at once. Concurrency simply means to allow things to occur simultaneously. In terms of computing, it can mean several processes running at once. Some processes create data, while some processes use data. When two processes need the same resource, they compete on who gets to use this data first. It is up to the operating system to decide which process uses it first. Once a process is selected, the resource is locked to that selected process and gives it exclusive rights. After that, the lock is released and the other process uses it. Concurrency can also occur in parallel processes. Some programs are written so that instead of having one big process, smaller chunks of processes are programmed to run simultaneously with each other. There are instances wherein during mid-execution of one thread, more data is needed and this data can be retrieved by running another thread. Essentially, thread A needs to wait for thread B to finish in order for thread A to continue execution. The operating system deploys synchronization methods via semaphores, so that these processes run optimally as possible and avoid any delays. Concurrency enables us to do more. It exists in operating systems in order to be convenient for the user, one of its main functions. It exists simply because fast CPUs exist, and we need to utilize the processing power. Think of it this way. You're a student, and you can choose to write down notes while not listening, or you can listen, however you can't jot down notes. Nothing is wrong with both approaches, but they are not effective. When you take down notes while listening, that is already concurrency, and this is much better. Hence, this is why we need concurrency in operating systems. My name is Junior Mitanya. Thank you for watching this video.